Hello students, today we are going to see 7 segment display interfacing to the microcontroller 8051. All of you are familiar with 7 segment displays. 7 segment displays are used to indicate numerical information. These can display digits from 0 to 9. So when you want to display the digits, you are actually using 7 segment display. Okay, it can display few characters like A, B, C, D, E, F, like this. A 7 segment display consists of 7 LEDs arranged in the form of a squarish 8 slightly inclined to the right and a single LED as the dot character. Okay, so those are actually arranged in the fashion of 8. Different characters can be displayed by selectively gluing the required LED segments. So let us see the LED. So this is the actual how it looks that is shown in this diagram. And these are the different terminals of the 7 segment display shown there. So the display, it looks like this 8 there. Okay. So the LEDs, this is individual segment, and such segments are actually arranged in the fashion of 8 here. Okay, and it is having the different terminals there. So for this is A, for A terminal we are having the for A LED we are having the terminal A, for B LED you are having the terminal B, for C LED you are having the terminal C, for D you are having D terminal, for E you are having E terminal, F, and then G, and this is dot point. Okay, along with that you are having common terminal also. Okay, so these are the terminals available with the 7 segment display. This is the way it looks like actually. Then the types of 7 segment display, there are two types of the 7 segment displays are there. One is common anode and second is common cathode. So it is decided by how you are connecting the common point for all the LEDs present in 7 segment display. According to that, there are two types. One is common anode and second is common cathode. So this is common anode display. So naturally, anodes of all the LEDs present there in the 7 segment display are tied together. And cathode terminal is kept free, which will be connected to the controlling circuitry. So you can see that this is the actual way these are arranged. The LEDs are arranged in this fashion: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and dot point. Okay, and for these LEDs, all anodes are tied together, and that is taken out as common terminal. Okay, so this is a common terminal which is anode of all the LEDs, therefore, it is called as common anode. Okay, so anode is connected together and that is taken out as common terminal, and for all the LEDs cathodes are taken as separate terminals. So you are having 8 terminals there: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and dot point. So these are actually cathodes are taken at the output. Okay, so this is a common anode 7 segment display. Now when you want to use this display, so to forward bias this LED, the anode is connected to the VCC. So at cathode you have to apply 0 there. Okay, so when you want to use common anode 7 segment display, here you have to apply 0 there. Okay, so for common anode is the 7 segment display, if I want to glow the particular LED, I have to make that particular terminal 0 there. Then it will turn on that LED. Okay, so according to this, I can display different digits by turning on that particular LED there. Say for example, I want to display 1. So when I want to display 1, I have to turn on LED B and LED C, or segment B and segment C. So what I have to do? I have to make segment B0, okay, and segment C0, and rest all other segments I will make it 1, okay. So when I make it like this, and if I give this code at that common anode 7 segment display, it is going to turn on segment B and segment C, or ultimately it will display 1 there. Okay. Then the next one, common cathode. Here the arrangement of the LED is same. They are arranged in the same fashion as 8, but the connection is having the difference there. Here all the cathodes of all the LEDs are tied together, and that is taken out as common terminal. Okay, so common terminal is cathode there, therefore it is called as common cathode display. And for every segment, the anode is taken out there. Okay, so for common cathode display, the terminal available is anode. So if I want to turn on that particular LED, I have to send their logic 1. I have to make that particular pin logic 1, then only it will turn on the LED. So if I want to display 1, means I have to turn on LED B and LED C, or segment B and segment C. So I have to make only these two bits 1, or these two pins 1, and remaining all pins I have to make 0 to display 1 there. Okay, so this is called as common cathode 7 segment display. Okay, so with this fundamentals of 7 segment display, we will go to the actual connection there. Okay, in this program, we are going to specifically use common cathode 7 segment display. We are going to interface common cathode 7 segment display to the microcontroller 8051. Okay, so this is one sample diagram I have taken. You have to make one change there. Instead of P1, you have to consider it as P2, because in the actual program I have used port 2. So just make that modification there. Okay, because I have taken the diagram as it is, so I was not able to change it. So what we have done there is we have used common cathode display, and this common cathode display is connected to port 2 pins. So remember, A is connected to P2.0, B is connected to P2.0, C is P2.1, C is connected to P2.2, D is connected to P2.3. And here you can see different resistors are also connected in series. This is current limiting resistance. Similar to the LED, you are having current limiting resistance. Okay, this is current limiting resistance, and this resistor is used to limit the current which is flowing from the controller into the 7 segment display. So this will avoid damage of the port pins. Okay, so for safety of your microcontroller, you are using current limit resistor. So these resistors will just limit the current, maximum current which is flowing through the circuit. Okay, so this is a connection diagram. You have to simply connect all the terminals of 7 segment display to the microcontroller port. Next, lookup table. Now for displaying, I have given you one example there. I want to display 1. Okay, so how I will send that code? So here you can see that A is connected, A terminal is connected to P2.0. okay, so lower bit of the port is always connected to the segment A, and higher bit is always connected to segment DP. Okay, so the sequence is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Or actually, if you want to prepare a lookup table, lookup table means it's a course for showing different numbers on your 7 segment display. So for this lookup table, okay, when I want to generate the code, the sequence I will take it like this. I will start from the LSB and I will go up to MSB like A, B, C, D, E, F, G and dot point. Okay. So, when I am going to display one, what was my requirement? I have to turn on segment B and segment C. So, I am making only segment B and C one and remaining all bits I am making it zero. Okay. Now, my number formed is 0, 0, 0, 0, first part, and 0, 1, 1, 0, second part. So, it is coming out as hex number is 0, 6. Okay, this is one example. We can similarly work on 0. So, for 0, I have to draw the pattern in that 8 format we have discussed for the 7 segment display. Okay. So, for this format, what I need is, I have to go with, I am not going to use this. Okay, so this is not used. The rest all other displays I have to glue there. So, A, B, C, then this is D segment. Okay, this is E segment and this is F segment. So, I have to make all this A to F segment, I have to make it one. So, the same thing is shown in first code. Okay, and G and dot point, only these two things we are going to make it zero. I don't want to display those segments. So, now make the group of four each. So, this is coming out as 0011 or it is hex 3 and the next one is 1111 or it is hex F. So, the code coming out is 0x3f. Okay. For 0, the code is 3f. For 1, it is 06. For 2, if you check it out, it will be 5e and then 4f and so on. If you want, I will cover one more. 8. 8 is very nice. Only dot point you are not going to display. So, rest all other bits are 1. So it will be 7f. Okay, so in that way we have given, I have given you the list of the codes for digits 0 to 9. So this is a lookup table we have prepared for interfacing common cathode 7 segment display. Now we will go for the program. So before going to the program, let us see some steps there. In the program, that is a procedure for implementation of counter. We are going to implement one counter, single digit counter, which will just go on showing the digits from 0 to 9 and it will repeat the sequence. Okay, so we will implement one single digit counter for microcontroller 8051 using 7 segment display. So the first step there is you have to write a delay function there. So normally in any microcontroller program you are requiring the delay. So by default you make the habit of writing one subroutine at the end of the program you can write it. Not necessarily you have to write it at the beginning. One subroutine you have to write for the delay function. Similarly you can write the lookup table in the code memory also. Okay, I will show you that in the program how to write it. How to write the lookup table in the code memory. So this is also important step in case of the this program. You will come to know how to access code memory in your program for anything. Okay, so you are going to use different move instructions, that is move C and move X instruction you have studied. So move C instruction, how it is used, that we are going to see in the lookup table. Then the next step is initialize the counter, initialize the memory pointer for code memory, then take the first code from the lookup table and send it to the 7 segment display, so it will display the first digit, and after that you have to repeat the all the above. Repeat step 5 for all the digits, so 0 to 9 digits will be repeated. After the completion of the 9th digit, then you have to repeat steps 3, 4, 5, 6. It means you have to once again initialize the counter, initialize the memory pointer and repeat the steps. Okay. So this is the procedure for the counter for 0 to 9 digits. Now the program. As usual, the first step is ORG 0000H. S jump to main. Initialize the port. Then two registers are used, and this is R6 is used for counting the number of digits. So we are using 10 digits, so therefore it is hash AH, or 10 also you can write it. It will convert it into A. Then we have used the lookup table. So for that I have defined one label there. Okay, so table is nothing but a label for the memory. So what is this? This is label. So this label is actually stored in the DPTR. So you know DPTR is the data pointer. This is a 16-bit register which is used to refer the code memory or data memory. So if you want to refer the code memory or data memory, external memory, you can use DPTR. External data memory or internal code memory also you can access using DPTR or data pointer. Next, we are storing the data in the register R2. This is used as a counter. Okay, now this is important instruction, MOVC A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. Okay, here it will take the contents of the code memory. Okay, so for code memory, I have to go to the further part of your program. I am currently accessing code memory of 8051 microcontroller. Okay, and for accessing that memory, I am using DPTR as a memory pointer. Okay, so here I have defined the this is your lookup table, and that is a part of your code memory. Normally we are writing it in RAM memory, but here we have written it in the code memory. So remember, if you want to store anything permanently, if you want to store any data permanently in the program for the 8051, you can store it in the code memory and you can access it using MOVC. You cannot modify it, but you can access the contents of the code memory using MOVC instruction. Now, check the syntax, how I have declared this memory area to store the code lookup table. Okay, so what you can see there is, this is the label given there. You can give any label there. You can give XYZ, your name, DKT, anything you can write. So what is this? It is not a keyword, but it is a name given there. Okay, it's a variable name there given, or it is actually, you can call it as a label given there. Okay, then the second one, this is called as directive. Okay, this directive will tell that microcontroller that you have to reserve a memory of byte. DB means define byte. Okay, I repeat it. DB means define byte. This is the directive which will allocate the memory space. Remember, in your program, some part will be your instructions and some part will be directives or something which will guide your microcontroller to perform a particular function, that is called as a directive. So DB directive is used here. This directive will allocate the memory of byte for everything which is written after this. So when I say DB3FH, it will allocate one byte to store the number 3FH. Okay, there are the other directives also, like DD, define double byte, double word. In that case, it will allocate 4 bytes for the same word. So it will depend upon how you are going to use the directive. DB means define byte you are using. So here I have declared one table. Whatever the codes we have implemented previously for the common cathode display, these are the codes we have discussed. Same codes are given here in the same sequence there. Okay, now coming back to the program, those codes are accessed here in the program. So I will first put 0 in the accumulator. Okay, 0 in the accumulator. So the first number will be first A plus DPTR. So DPTR is currently pointing to the first location. So A is pointing as 0. So 0 plus this location, that is 300 location. This is 300. This is 301, 302, 303, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Like that I am having the memory locations present there. So when I say A plus DPTR, I am taking the contents of the first memory location in table. Okay. Next, I am sending it to the port 2. Why I am sending it to the port 2? Because here 7 segment display is connected to 8051. Okay. And then a call delay, wait for some time until that digit is displayed there. So for that we are calling the delay routine. Okay. So this is subroutine. For calling the subroutine, we are using the instruction ACALL. Next is, so first number is displayed, 0. Now what we need is, we have to display the second number, 1. So for displaying 1, you have to go to the second location in the table. So here what I am doing, I am incrementing the DPTR. It will point to the second location. Clear A means A will be 0. But now DPTR is 301. Okay, A I am every time clearing, but DPTR will be incremented by 1 every time. So now it will point to the code of 1. Okay, then decrement DJ NZ R2 to up. Means every time I will go on decrementing R2, it will count up to 0 to 9, that is 10 numbers it will display. And after displaying that, jump to the main means it will reinitialize everything and it will execute it. Okay, and then here, this is the delay routine which we have already seen in the previous program. This is simply just making that microcontroller busy for some time and we are calling it as a delay routine. Okay, so this is the program for the 7 segment display interfacing, and this is the output of the program. Here, port 2 is used to connect the port 2 is used here to connect the 7 segment display. Okay, and when you are connecting this display to the port 2, we are using the series resistors. These are all current limiting resistors, and when we dump the program in this IC, we are getting the actually counting of the numbers 0 to 9, and once it reaches the 9, once again it will be reinitialized to 0. And it will start counting from 0 to 9 again. Okay. So this is all about the interfacing there. We have interfaced. So I will just repeat the points which we have discussed. We have seen that 7 segment display is interfaced to the 8051 microcontroller. There are two types of the 7 segment displays. Common cathode and common anode. Here we have this interface common cathode display. It's a single digit display we have interfaced. Port 2 is used to interface it. Okay, then we are having the lookup table. Lookup table is nothing but it's a set of codes to display different numbers on the 7 segment display. So according to the way the number will look in the arrangement of those 7 segment or 7 LEDs, according to that we are generating the codes and we are calling those codes as 7 segment codes. Okay, so we are preparing the lookup table. In the main program, we have written one delay routine, we have prepared one lookup table which is also the part of the code memory, and then to access the code memory, we cannot use simple move instruction, we have used MOVC instruction. And using MOVC instruction, we have transferred one by one the codes to the 7 segment display. Okay, you can extend it for 2 digit display also. Only thing is you have to make the slight change in the logic so that you can display the two different digits. By using the persistence of vision, you can get the result of, or you can actually create the effect of two digit displayed simultaneously. Okay, so with this we will stop here. We have seen the 7 segment display interfacing to the 8051 microcontroller. Okay, thank you students.